Hey, Dr. Backman here. Let's talk about basic navigation in the terminal of a Unix-like operating system. We'll be creating and manipulating files and directories, and learning to copy, move, and delete them as well. Okay, let's go. When starting a terminal, you'll see text displayed that we call a prompt. This prompt largely indicates that it's just waiting for your input, but it also can display some interesting things as well. In this case, it's displaying three things. One, the username that I'm logged in as, that's Backman. Two, the name of the computer that I'm connected to, in this case it's called K. And three, it indicates the current directory that the terminal is working from. Being aware of your current directory is actually really important, because everything that you do in a terminal happens with respect to the current directory that you're in. It's similar to being in Windows Explorer on Windows or Finder in Mac OS, where you're working through a hierarchical set of directories and you kind of have to remember where you are in the midst of all of that. When opening a new terminal, it's most common for your current working directory to be your home directory. Now, there's a single home directory for each user account in the system, and it's basically where you store all your files and your home base of operations. These home directories exist in Windows and Mac OS as well, but in Unix-like systems, it's a bit more central and apparent to the user. Now, there's one piece of shorthand that's actually really important to know, and that's called the tilde symbol. And that's the little squiggly line there if you haven't heard the name of it before. That's shorthand for the home directory. So whenever you see that tilde symbol, know that it's referring to your home directory. When we look back to the terminal that I'm logged into right now, you can see that I'm logged in as user Backman on computer K, and I'm in my home directory. Now that we know who and where we are, it's time to start playing around. The first thing we should do is just start looking around to see what other files or directories are here. We can do that by typing in ls, which stands for list, and we can list the contents of the current directory. So I'll hit enter and nothing. There's not a whole lot going on here. So let's get started by making a directory. To make a new directory, you type mkdir, which stands for make directory, and then you provide a name for the directory that you intend to create. I'm going to go with the theme of computer science courses and name this directory after our Computer Science 1 course, CMSC181. Hit enter, and it should be there. Let's check by typing ls to list the contents of the current directory. There it is, we've got a directory. On the left side of the screen, I've created a visualization that shows you the impacts of the commands that we're running. So as we create and manipulate files and directories, this visualization will be updated so you can see sort of what's happening with respect to the commands that we're running. Now let's try to move into this new directory so that we can make it our current working directory. To change directories, you type in cd and then specify the name of the directory that you want to move into. In this case, CMSC181. And then we'll hit enter, and there you go. Now notice that the prompt has changed. It shows that the directory we're currently in is /CMSC181. Now that's /CMSC181. Let's make a few homework directories for our CMSC181 course. So we'll type in mkdir again and specify the name of the directories. We'll call it hw_1 for homework 1, and then make directory hw_2 for homework 2. Now with two subdirectories in our working directory, if we type ls, we should be able to see the results. And there we go, homework 1, homework 2, both in our current working directory, which is CMSC181. Now I want to create a file, but I want to do it in my homework 1 directory, so I want to move into that homework 1 directory, which we can do by typing cd hw_1. And now by hitting enter, you'll see that the prompt is updated and it shows our new current location, our new working directory. To create this new file, I'm going to use a terminal-based text editor, and it's called nano. To use it, we type nano, and then we name the file that we'd like to edit or modify or create. In this case, we'll create a file called todo.txt. All right. This looks different. Since we're in the nano text editor, we're free to type any text we'd like to store into this file. Since we're in a homework 1 folder for a computer science course, let's leave a note to create a hello world program in Python, the Python programming language. Okay. That should do it. At the bottom of the screen in Nano, you'll see something of a menu that describes certain keyboard shortcuts that allows Nano to take specific actions. For instance, in the bottom left, we see this upper caret X, which stands for exit. That means Control X, the keyboard sequence Control with X at the same time. So let's try that option to exit Nano, Control X. At this point, I'm being asked if I want to save the file before exiting, and I want to type Y for yes. Now it's asking me to confirm the name of the file I intend to write, and I'm fine with todo.txt, so I'll hit enter. And there we go. We just saved and quit. Now type ls and hit enter. And now you see our file here, displayed in white, actually, which is different than the other things, which were displayed in blue. Those other things displayed in blue were directories, and then this file here is in white. It's just a nice little differentiation that allows you to keep track of the files and directories that exist. Alright, so let's actually create a hello world file now. So we'll do that with nano, and we'll say hello.py for a Python file. Typing print hello world ought to do the trick. I'll save and quit with Control X, yes, to say that I want to save this file, enter to confirm the name of the file, and there we go. And to confirm that this file exists, we'll type in ls again, and now we see hello.py and todo.txt, both existing within our current directory. Just for fun, let's try running our Python program by invoking the Python interpreter. We can do that by typing python 3 and then naming the file that we created, hello.py. Hit enter, and we have our hello world. Well, the todo file isn't needed any longer, so we can get rid of that. You can delete a file by typing in rm and then typing in the name of the file you intend to delete. For us, that will be todo.txt. We'll press enter and then ls to see that it's gone, and no more todo file. Suppose we want to make a copy of our hello world file, something like a hello world 2.0. To make a copy of a file, you type cp, you specify the file that you want to copy, hello.py, and then you type the destination location of the file you want to produce. In this case, let's call it hello_2.py. We'll hit enter, type ls, and now you can see we have two hello world files. Alright, I think we're done with our Computer Science 1 course for now. Let's go back towards our home directory. But how do we go back? We haven't talked about that yet. We definitely need to type cd to change directories, but there's a little piece of shorthand that's really useful for going back a directory, up a directory towards the parent, and that's dot dot. So we can type in cd dot dot and then hit enter. Now notice that our prompt has changed and the current working directory has updated to CMSC181. We've gone back, we've gone up one directory. Let's do it once more and get back to the home directory by typing in cd dot dot yet again. And now we can see that we're in just tilde, the home directory. Here's another little tip. If you just type in cd and immediately hit enter, then it will take you directly to your home directory, no matter what your current working directory is. That's actually a really handy shortcut. Well, now that we've got this CMSC181 directory structure for our Computer Science 1 course, let's just replicate it and use it as the foundation for our Computer Science 2 course, CMSC182. We can do this pretty easily with the copy command cp to copy CMSC181 to CMSC182, but there is one little bit of a difference that's required for copying directories. And that's that immediately after typing cp, you need to add a dash r. And this specifies that we want to recursively copy the contents of the original directory into that new location. So in this case, we can type cp dash r CMSC181, followed by CMSC182, our destination folder, and hit enter. Let's type ls to see what we've got. And there we go, a brand new CMSC182 directory standing right next to our CMSC181 directory. So one little side distinction I should make is that our CMSC181 course is taught in Python and our CMSC182 course is taught in C++. So I should really go into our CMSC182 folder and change all those files from being Python files to C++ files. I'm going to create another todo text file to note all of that. So nano todo.txt. And change all of the Python files to C++ files. All right, Control X. Yes, I want to save the buffer. Confirm the file name. Okay, but wait, this todo file doesn't really belong in my home directory. It belongs in the homework 1 folder of my CMSC182 directory. So let's move it there. To move a file, you type mv, short for move, and then specify the file you want to move, todo.txt in this case, and we'd like to push it into the homework 1 folder of CMSC182. So you'll type in the destination you'd like it to go to, which would be CMSC182/homework_1/todo.txt, and then hit enter. So notice here that we typed a path to the destination point, which traversed through a couple of directories, and we did it all relative to where we currently are, the current working directory. That's actually called a relative path, and we should get familiar with the notion of using relative paths. And let's now type the path of the folder we want to get to. So we could type cd CMSC182 and then cd homework1, but let's just do it all in one shot with a relative path. Cd CMSC182/HW_1. Enter. We'll see that our path updated in our prompt, which is great. And now we can type ls to see what we've got. And here we've got the copied Python files as well as this todo file. Now, to rename these Python files. I haven't exactly talked about how to do that, but we have used a command that can be used to rename files, and that's the move command, mv. Now watch this. I'll move hello.py to a new location, and this time I'm going to call it hello.cpp for our C++ file, and I'll hit enter. ls. And now you can see that we've updated the file name just by moving it from the current directory to the same directory, but with a new file name as its destination point. Now let's do the same with the next file. Move hello underscore 2.py to hello underscore 2.cpp. Enter and ls. Now both of our Python files have been updated to CPP files. Excellent. I think we're done with our CMSC 182 course now, so let's go back to the home directory. We could do this just by typing cd and hitting enter, that cool shortcut I talked about before, or we could type cd dot dot followed by cd dot dot, but let's get used to the notion of relative paths again. We can chain these things together by typing in cd dot dot, which would get us back to the CMSC 182 directory, but then followed by a slash dot dot yet again to take us to its parent directory, the home directory. If we hit enter, we'll see that the prompt is updated to just tilde, just our home directory. We're about done here, but there's one last thing that I want to show you how to do, and that's how to delete a directory. So let's just delete our computer science 2 directory, CMSC 182. We saw before that you can type an rm to remove a file name, deleting a file. To delete a directory, it's very similar, but just like CP, there's one little extra piece of information that you need, and that's to specify that we want to delete the contents of the directory recursively. So rm-r CMSC 182 for the directory we want to delete. We'll hit enter, and now let's type ls. All we have left is CMSC 181. The CMSC 182 directory is now gone. All right, we've done it. That was a great start. Now you've seen a lot of the basics. We covered making directories with mkdir. We talked about listing the contents of directory with ls. We talked about copying files with cp, moving files with mv, removing files, deleting files with rm, and we even talked about editing and creating files with nano. A good start. Now, go off and change the world, or at least the contents of your home directory. Have fun.